Okay, the problem statement is like this: a prestressed concrete beam, I beam, supports a live load of 4,000 newton per meter over a simply supported beam of 8 meter span. The beam has overall depth 400 mm, and the, so depth of beam they have given 400 mm. So you can consider that depth is 400 mm. Total beam depth, I section beam. So 400 mm is the depth of beam. Okay. Next thing, they have given the thickness of each flange and wave 60 mm and 80 mm respectively. So first flange and wave. So flange 60 mm. So flange 60 mm and wave 80 mm. And they have given width of flange also. So thickness 60 mm and 80 mm respectively, with the width of each flange is 200 mm. So width of flange also they have given. So width of flange is 200 mm. Okay. So this is given data for the beam. So if you are going to minus this flange from the total web, so here the web depth we can write here that value 280 mm. So this is the beam, and what they have asked us, see, the beam is to be prestressed by effective prestressing force of 235 kN. Jya beam var 235 kN se force lagnar hai, prestressing force. Applied at suitable eccentricity. Here they have not given the value of eccentricity here. Suitable eccentricity la आपल्याला tendon provide करायचं आहे, such that की अशा प्रकारे आपल्याला tendon provide करायचं आहे, the resultant stress at the bottom of the beam at the center, म्हणजे mid section, at the mid section, the resultant stress at bottom will be zero. म्हणजे काय आलं पाहिजे, बॉटमचा जो स्ट्रेस आहे, I can show you. जर आपली डायग्राम जर अशी असेल तर त्यांना काय पाहिजे, इफ बीम इज लाईक दिस, अर्लियर वी हॅव कॅल्क्युलेट द वरियस स्ट्रेसेस, इफ यू आर गोइंग टू सी द डायग्राम ऍट स्ट्रेसेस ऍट एंड, टॉपला स्ट्रेसेस त्यांना चालतील, पण बॉटमला स्ट्रेस किती असायला पाहिजे, दिस व्हॅल्यू शुड बी झिरो. कंडिशन अशी आहे की तुम्ही टेंडन अशा प्रकारे प्रोव्हाइड करा की जेव्हा जर तुम्ही टेंडन प्रोव्हाइड केलात तर त्या टेंडन मुळे इथं जो येणारा बॉटम स्ट्रेस आहे त्याची व्हॅल्यू समजा पी बाय ए, मग ते एम बाय झेड प्लस मायनस काय याच्यावर डिपेंड असेल, एम बाय झेड याची व्हॅल्यू, दिस व्हॅल्यू शुड बी झिरो, अशी कंडिशन आपल्याला दिली. मग या केसमध्ये पी इंटू हिअर मुवमेंट यू कॅन राईट पी इंटू ई, अँड इफ इसेंट प्रीस्ट्रेसिंग फोर्स इज प्रोव्हाइडेड, वी कॅन कॅल्क्युलेट द एरिया ऑफ बीम, वी कॅन कॅल्क्युलेट द सेक्शन मॉड्युलस ऑफ बीम, यू कॅन गेट द मुवमेंट. So only unknown here eccentricity, that eccentricity value we can calculate. So simple thing, they have given the condition, based upon that condition we are going to calculate the eccentricity. Okay, so first thing here they have asked, find the eccentricity required for the prestressing force. Yeah, prestressing force sathi kiti eccentricity paije, that we have to calculate. And second, if tendon is concentric, the tendons are concentric asel, what should be the magnitude of a prestressing force for the resultant stress to be zero at the bottom fiber at the center section. Je te parat idha tes sangitle, jar tendon is concentrated, the tendon concentrated with the load asel, so what be the magnitude of prestressing force, so the prestressing force magnitude kiti asli paije, that we have to calculate. Okay, so one by one we are going to solve, to try to solve this problem. So first thing required, as usual, so first thing here we have to calculate the cross sectional area of the beam. Okay, so what is the cross sectional area of the beam? Someone please take calculator with you. So cross sectional area, here we are going to consider first this two flange area and the wave area. So two flange area, flange having depth 60 mm into width 200 mm and two numbers of flange, so into 2 plus area of web, wave having depth 280 mm into width of wave 80 mm. So calculate the area and tell me the area, cross section area of the I-beam. जे आंसर सांगितलं त्याला दोन मार्क एक्स्ट्रा देणार आहे बरं का, म्हणजे असाइनमेंट असेल किंवा
सर 46400 सर बीबी 40
नेम नाव काय तुझं
सर बीबी 40 मुंबई वाले
40 मुंबई वाले ओके गुड मुंबई वाले सो एरिया इज हियर 46400 एमएम स्क्वायर सो दिस हाउ वी आर कॅल्क्युलेट द क्रॉस सेक्शनल एरिया ऑफ द बीम ओके नेक्स्ट थिंग वी आर गोइंग टू कॅल्क्युलेट द मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया ओके सो मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया ऑफ द बीम Why moment of inertia we have to calculate? Someone let me know. Sangu shakal mala kuni? Why we need to calculate
inertia? To calculate section modulus.
Section modulus, correct. So moment of inertia, how we are going to calculate the moment of inertia? We are going to consider first. बघा इथे काय करतो बघा, अजून रिपीट करतो, मग सांगितलं तुम्हाला मी काय करतोय, याच्यामध्ये हा पूर्ण पहिल्यांदा रेक्टॅंगल कन्सिडर करतो मी पूर्ण ओके. सो तसा एरिया काय झाला, सेक्शन मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया फॉर्म्युला यु नो, बीडी क्यूब बाय 12 ओके. पण हा कॅल्क्युलेट करताना वेन आय एम गोइंग टू कॅल्क्युलेट that value, first I am going to consider this as a whole section, apurna consider karto, okay, and when I am going to consider this full, b is here in this case, so b is here 200 and depth is 400, so 200 kunacha here mute kara de kon hai mumbai wale okay, so b into d is 400 here, so 2 into 400 cube, so 200 into 400 cube divided by 12 minus what we have to do here, we have considered this section, full section, but our beam is only having the flange and web, so our beam don't have this part, so this part in beam we don't have, so we have to subtract the moment of inertia of this part, so moment of first we have to calculate b and d of this, so b is here, this is 200, this is 80, so remaining here 120 divided by 2, so this is 60 and this is also 60, so 60 plus 120, so I'm going to consider here 120 is total width into depth of web is 280, so 280 cube divided by 12, so I'm going to get now total moment of value of moment of inertia for the section in mm port, so tell me the value, I is equal to करा कोणीतरी मुंबईला एक आन्सर दिला, मुंबई वेल गोइंग टू गेट 2 मार्क एक्स्ट्रा इन इच टर्म मार्क्स ऑफ डीसीएस
846 इनटू 10 रेस्ट टू 6 एमएम 4
आई इज इक्वल टू विटकर किती
846 इनटू 10 रेस्ट टू 6
846 इनटू 10 रेस्ट टू
6 एमएम 4
एमएम 4 ओके, सो वी हैव गॉट वैल्यू ऑफ नाउ मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया आई okay, so next thing we are going to calculate now section modulus okay, so section modulus for beam, I section beam, so section modulus z is equal to I by y, so I value just we have calculated, so 846 into 10 dash to 6 divided by how much value of I we are going to consider, kiti consider karna sang I value good apala cg la ghaycha ka, this is symmetric beam okay, jar tumhi cg consider kela ithun, so this value will be 200 mm, So here we have to consider the value of I, 200 mm. So I'm going to put value here 200. We are calculating here section modulus. Section modulus of beam. So let me know the value of section modulus. Z is equal to
4.23 into 10 raised to 6.
Into 10 raised to 6. Okay, mm cube. So this is how you got the value of section modulus. Kon sangitla answer? Now sanga mala.
Sir, Mumbai wale.
Mumbai wale. Okay. Dogas bolta hai lecture madhe 48 participants. पण बाकी बोलणारे किंवा करणारे फक्त दोघच. ओके, नेक्स्ट थिंग, आफ्टर गेटिंग द सेक्शन मॉड्युलस नेक्स्ट वी हॅव टू कॅल्क्युलेट द डेड लोड ऑफ बीम. सो समवन लेट मी नो द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ डेड लोड ऑफ बीम. हाऊ वी आर गोइंग टू कॅल्क्युलेट व्हॅल्यू ऑफ डेड लोड ऑफ बीम. डेड लोड ऑफ द बीम पर मीटर वी हॅव टू कॅल्क्युलेट. सो एरिया इन टू डेन्सिटी ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट वी हॅव टू डू. So area of beam, if you are going to convert into meter, so that value will be 0.0464 into density of concrete 25,000. So that value become 1160 newton per meter. Check. काय केलं बघ सगळ्यांना. We have calculated the area of beam. See here, area of beam, cross section area of beam 46,400 mm². Okay, we have converted that into meter. Okay, and density of concrete we have considered 25 kN/m³. So here we have considered in newton meter cube. So that value is 25,000. So dead load of beam 1160 newton meter. Okay, now after getting the dead load, next thing we are going to do, dead load bending moment. Okay, due to this dead load, what will be the bending moment? So dead load bending moment, so dead load bending moment, bending moment will be W L² / 8. So W, how much value they have given? So you can see the problem here. For live load they have given 400, and for dead load we have to consider the self weight of beam. So this is 400 newton meter they have given for the live load, and for dead load of due to bending moment due to the dead load we have to consider this 1160 newton meter. So if you are going to put value here 1160 into length of beam 8 meter, so 8 meter² divided by 8, so you are going to get the bending moment value here 9280 newton meter. Someone check and let me know whether it is correct or not. Calculate karun sanga kunitir mala correct again.
Yes sir,
correct.
Okay, so after getting the bending moment, next thing you are going to calculate live load bending moment. This is due to the dead load. Now to what is bending moment due to live load that we are going to consider. So live load bending moment, so live load bending moment, so bending moment m is equal to again WL² / 8. Let me know the value of W here. Koni sangu shakel mala W value kiti gaiche apan ta for live load. So how much W I can take here? Pura problem jat nahi bo tumhi sangitle shivay.
4000.
Kuni sangitle answer?
Sir, Arun Kodur.
Arun Kodur ek wadla kontra bolnar amala. Theek hai, 4000 into L is 8² divided by 8. तिघांचे नाव लिहून ठेवलं मी, अरुण कोडूर, मुंबई वाले आणि विटकर. So total movement here. Let me do answer. Kuni sangel answer is sir.
32,000 sir.
Kedi?
32,000.
Kuni sangel answer?
Sir Mumbai wale.
Mumbai wale. Correct. Good Mumbai wale. So movement value you have got here 32,000 newton meter. Okay. So after getting this all basic thing, whatever things we have calculated now, so this required for the solving the problem, we have first seen the I section beam, we have calculated the cross section area, moment of inertia for the beam, then we have calculated the section modulus of the beam, we have calculated the dead load of the beam by considering the self weight of beam, and dead load we have calculated the bending moment for dead load, and we have calculated the bending moment for the live load. After getting this all initial required data, now we have to consider the first case. What is given in first case and how we are going to solve the how we are going to calculate the eccentricity required in a first case. So for case number first, so what is case number first? When tender is placed eccentrically, when the tender is placed eccentrically, so in this case we have to calculate the value. So case number first, they are asked find the eccentricity required for the pre-stressing force. That eccentricity we have to calculate. So let the eccentricity of here, we are first initially we are going to consider, let the eccentricity is equal to EMM. Apan unknown thevta eccentricity la, that eccentricity we have to calculate. Okay, so as usual we have to calculate the required data. Kay kay apla data required problem madhe stresses calculate kartana, kay karto apan first kartana direct stress. Okay, so first we are going to calculate the direct stress. So direct stress is equal to काय फॉर्म्युला direct stress चा कोणी सांगेल? तीनच लोक बोलले आतापर्यंत लेक्चर मध्ये.
P by A
कोण सांगितलं?
अरुण कोडोर
परत. ओके, गुड अरुण. सो P by A, आणि जेवढं तुम्ही मला बोलता तेवढं मला ओळखी तुमची जास्त वाढेल, जेणेकरून तुम्हाला बाबा मार्क पण झाला आणि बाकी गोष्टीमध्ये पण वी कॅन हेल्प यू. ओके, सो डायरेक्ट स्ट्रेस P by A, we have to consider sine plus. Why we have to consider sine plus? Kuni sangu shakel mala? Bagu 49 madhe
compression.
Direct stress always in a compression, so that's why we have to consider plus sign. So we have to put the value here. So what is pre-stressing force? P value sanga mala kitiye? Read the proceed the problem. Pre-stressing force.
235 sir.
235. So 235 into 10 raised to 3 and area, cross section area of beam. Sanga kundri value mala? Kidi hai?
46400.
Calculate the value and tell me the stress. Direct stress in the beam.
5.064.
5.064. Okay, so this is in newton per mm square, because we have considered the force in newton, this area in mm square. So this value here plus, so we have calculated direct stress as value 5.06. Next thing we are going to calculate the extreme stress due to the eccentricity of the pre-stressing force. Okay, so next we are going to calculate the extreme stresses. Extreme stresses due to eccentricity of the pre-stressing force. So how we are going to calculate the eccentricity? So you know, when you are going to consider the forces or stresses due to eccentricity we are going to calculate, we have to consider minus plus P into eccentricity by Z. Now tell me why we have considered here negative sign and positive sign. Sangu shakala mala kuni? Why
at top fiber it is in tension and at bottom it is in compression.
Okay, right. I will explain you. Correct. So if I am going to consider this is a beam, okay, and now we don't know the where they have provided the tendon. Suppose now they have. Suppose this is centered axis of the beam. Okay, and they have provided tendon. Suppose they have provided tendon somewhere here. So what happened? This is eccentricity. Okay, and pre-stressing force is going to apply here somewhere. This is P. And here also that is going to act as a P. So what happened due to this force into eccentricity, force and eccentricity is going to convert into the moment. So this moment is going to apply like this. And due to this moment, if moment is going to apply in this way, the beam is going to bend like this. Beam asa bend hona hai. And what happened in this case of the beam? Tension. Where is the tension? Tension is at top of beam. And when we are going to consider tension, we are going to use negative sign. So tension is at top and compression is at bottom. Okay. So this is how you are going to consider the various things when you are going to consider the eccentricity in pre-stressing force. Okay. Got it? Kala sakana hai? Why we have considered negative and positive? Because this is two sides, okay, at the of the neutral axis, opposite side, or two top side and the bottom side. Hope that this point is clear to you people. So next here, after we have to calculate now the value here. So we have to put the value here. So minus plus. What is value of P? So P 235 into 10 raised to 3 pre-stressing force into eccentricity we have to calculate. So that eccentricity we have assumed as E. Okay. And next here we have to consider the section modulus. Section modulus here. Value of section modulus. Let me know the value of section modulus. Sanga kani thiri? What is value of section modulus?
4.23 into 10 raised to 6.
4.23
into 10 raised to 6.
Into 10 raised to 6. So if you are going to calculate this value, let me know the value of in terms of E. A calculation karan in terms of E madhi sangamala value kiti. Kodur Mumbai wale ani Whitaker sodun baki konek ka?
0.055 e
minus plus 0.00
5 no sir only 10 minus zip minus plus 0.055
okay. So this is the stress in terms of E. Okay, E is still unknown. We have to calculate of value of E. Okay, so next thing you have to calculate now, extreme stresses due to the bending moment, dead load. Okay, so due to dead load bending moment, extreme stresses due to dead load bending moment. So dead load bending moment, so that value you people know when you are going to calculate the stresses by dead load and live load. In that case, we are going to use formula plus minus This is due to dead load, so that's why we are going to use here MD, moment due to dead load, and divided by Z. So moment due to dead load already we have calculated. Okay, so what is that value of bending moment due to dead load we have calculated?
9280 newton per meter.
Yes, we have calculated dead load bending moment. So 9280 newton meter. Okay, so if I'm going to put that value here, 9280 into 1000, so divided by here, section modulus 4.23 into 10 raised to 6. So let me know the value, extreme stresses due to the dead load. Plus कौन सा इनले girls में देखा हूँ कौन है name?
Sir प्रतीक्षा गायकवाड़ A13.
प्रतीक्षा गायकवाड़ okay good. So 2.19 newton per mm square. So we have got this value. Now we have to calculate again extreme stresses due to live load. So extreme stresses. So this is due to the extreme stress due to the dead load. Now extreme stresses due to extreme stresses due to live load, and that bending moment we have to calculate. So formula again remains same, but only instead of that value of D, here we have to consider ML, that is due to moment due to live load. So moment we have calculated due to live load, you can see here, due to die load 32,000 moment we have calculated. So 32,000 newton meter we have to convert into meter. So 32,000 convert into mm. So 1000 divided by section modulus 4.23 into 10 raised to 6. कौन मुंबई वाले का?
Yes sir, 7.56.
So total here value
7.56.
Plus minus 7.56 newton per mm square. So we have calculated now all the stresses. Now what is condition they have given? That is important. Ghost bagaja madhe. Idhar kaam sopa hai. Next condition kya dile maithi ne aplela? Pehla problem bagaja madhe kya sangitla manje? Problem madhe kya sangitla? Important thing here. See here. Hecha jar tumhala ardha kalala. So that is you can easily calculate the eccentricity. Baga kaam madhe? A pressed effective pre-stressing force 235 is applied to suitable eccentricity such that kya pudu the resultant stress at the bottom of beam at center of span is zero. Center of span means mid section la. Okay, at mid section bottom la stress kiti asla paije this value pudu baka such that the resultant stress at bottom of beam center span is zero paije stress. मग ते जर पाहिजे असेल तर आपल्याला काय करायला लागेल वी हॅव टू यूज फॉर्म्युला कुठला फॉर्म्युला यूज करायचा आपल्याला बॉटम स्ट्रेस जर असेल तर हाऊ यू आर गोइंग टू कॅल्क्युलेट द स्ट्रेसेस ॲट बॉटम ऑफ द बीम बघा आपण काय करतो एक्स्ट्रीम स्ट्रेसेस बॉटम एक्स्ट्रीम स्ट्रेसेस ॲट बॉटम ऑफ द बीम बघा तिथे लिहितो आपण एक्स्ट्रीम स्ट्रेसेस ॲट बॉटम ऑफ बीम सिग्मा बी काय आलं पाहिजे सांगा मला सिग्मा बी चे स्ट्रेसेस काय आलं पाहिजे डायरेक्ट स्ट्रेस आला पाहिजे प्लस पी बाय ए परत काय आलं पाहिजे परत काय आलं पाहिजे यामध्ये स्ट्रेस इसेंट्रिसिटी इसेंट्रिसिटी म्हणून काय आलं पाहिजे स्ट्रेसेस मग आपण काय करतोय कन्सिडर बॉटमला म्हणतोय मी टॉपला नाही बॉटमला काय आलं पाहिजे हे प्लस पी इंटू ई बाय झेड राईट आणि इकडे टेन्शनला काय आलं पाहिजे बॉटमला काय आलं पाहिजे मायनस एम बाय झेड कळतं तुम्हाला हे एक्स्ट्रीम स्ट्रेसेस झाले ऑलरेडी वी हॅव सीन दिस केसेस म्हणजे बीमला जर तुम्हाला तीन गोष्टी पाहिजे दिस इज डायरेक्ट स्ट्रेस दिस इज स्ट्रेस ड्यू टू द इसेंट्रिसिटी अँड दिस स्ट्रेस ड्यू टू द बेंडिंग मोमेंट आता तुम्ही आपण जे कॅल्क्युलेट केलेत व्हॅल्यू ते कॅल्क्युलेट काय केलं माहितीये तर बघा असं काय आपण कॅल्क्युलेट केलं मायनस प्लस पी इंटू ई बाय झेड आणि इथं कॅल्क्युलेट करताना आपण काय केलं प्लस मायनस एम बाय झेड अशा व्हॅल्यू कॅल्क्युलेट केले. पण हे प्लस मायनस कधी घ्यायचं? दिस मायनस वी आर गोइंग टू कॅल्क्युलेट व्हेन वी आर गोइंग टू कॅल्क्युलेट द स्ट्रेसेस ऍट टॉप अँड स्ट्रेसेस ऍट बॉटम. इथे पण असं आहे, व्हेन वी आर गोइंग टू कॅल्क्युलेट द स्ट्रेसेस ऍट टॉप फायबर ऑफ द बीम वी हॅव टू कन्सिडर दिस प्लस अँड दिस वी हॅव टू कन्सिडर एज अ मायनस. आता आपल्याला काय कंडिशन दिली आहे? द कंडिशन दे हॅव गिव्हन इन द प्रॉब्लेम, काय कंडिशन दिली आहे बघा, द रिझल्टंट स्ट्रेस ऍट द बॉटम ऑफ बीम. बघा रिझल्टंट स्ट्रेस कुठं? बॉटम ऑफ बीम. किती आहे? बॉटम ऑफ बीमला झिरो आहे. मग आपण आपल्याला माहिती आहे, वी नो दॅट एक्स्ट्रीम स्ट्रेसेस ऍट बॉटम ऑफ बीम वी आर गोइंग टू कॅल्क्युलेट बाय युजिंग दिस फॉर्म्युला. ही व्हॅल्यू ते म्हणतात की झिरो आहे. नो वी हॅव गॉट द इक्वेशन. काय इक्वेशन मिळालं आपल्याला? वी हॅव गॉट इक्वेशन दॅट प्लस पी बाय ए, सो मायनस पी इंटू डिवाइड बाय पी इंटू ई डिवाइड बाय झेड, सो मायनस एम बाय, सॉरी दिस इज प्लस, सो मायनस एम बाय झेड, सो दिस टोटल विल बी झिरो. आता इथे इक्वेशन आपल्याकडे इक्वेशन तयार झालं, वी हॅव गॉट द इक्वेशन. नाव इन दिस इक्वेशन विच थिंग इज अननोन, विच टर्म इज अननोन? पी बाय ए यू पीपल,
इसेंट्रिसिटी.
Eccentricity is only unknown. So this eccentricity value you can get. And already we have calculated these values. P by A, P into E by Z. This value already we have calculated. So what are those values we have calculated? You can see here. What is value of P by A? P by H value kiti calculate kele apan? Kiti value? Plus 5.06. So I can write here. Plus 5.06. Then P into E by Z. So P into E by Z, that value, that stress we have calculated here, plus minus, minus is at top, plus at bottom, 0.055 E. So that value I'm going to put here, 0.055. How much that value? 55. Okay. And eccentricity E. So here, in terms of eccentricity, I have put the value, and then minus M by Z. M by Z also we have calculated. So M by Z value, okay, so M by Z value you have calculated due to the live load, 7.56. okay, so by considering that value I'm going to put here live load, in the live load case, so that value is 7.55 is equal to 0. Now if you are going to solve this, you are going to get the value of eccentricity. So what is value of eccentricity? Let me know. So E is equal to, सांगा कोणतरी आन्सर मला. E इज इक्वल टू, व्हॉट इज व्हॅल्यू ऑफ
45.27.
सॉरी सॉरी, हियर वी हॅव टू कन्सिडर द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ ड्यू टू डेड लोड ऑल्सो. सो मायनस 7.55, सॉरी मायनस द व्हॅल्यू ड्यू टू द डेड लोड, सो दॅट ऑल्सो 2.9 इज इक्वल टू 0. नाऊ कॅल्क्युलेट टेल मी. I have missed that value due to the dead load. Just I have taken the value due to the live load.
85.09.
Then कौन सांगितलं? मुंबई वाले आणि कौन है?
85.09.
Girl मध्ये कौन है? Girl कौन? प्रतीक्षा गायकवाड आहे का? सांगितलं answer?
Yes sir, yes.